So organizational structure definitely plays a role in terms of how successful a DevOps transformation can be. And I think this is where it's important to understand that as a DevOps practitioner, you are taking a set of software development and operational practices as a base. But maybe what you are really doing is you're doing some community organization. And so I think it's important to understand that your role is one of someone who is promoting change. And this is different from being a change agent. So often people think of themselves as, I'm the change agent. And so, sorry, change agents, but the way that that role then gets played is you run around inside the organization seeking permission for change. And so in a very hierarchical organization, you know, the pattern that that's going to take is you're in an organizational silo. You see that maybe you could reach out to the silo right next to you, but your only path for communication is straight up, maybe up to the point at which there's two people playing golf, right? And then all the way back down to the bottom. And that takes time, it's frustrating, and often you go unheard. I think the real limitation there is the limitation of language. So I think it's maybe more important inside of an organization that is heavily siloed or sort of heavily structured in that way to take actions that support your goals in ways that are safe, but that can also communicate value. For instance, even in the strongest silo, when you can identify real organizational pain points and take a step toward alleviating them, and in today's world, these can be done using open source projects. There are many ways in which they can be these problems can be approached with a lightweight experiment. That's sort of low cost. I think that's when you are having now a conversation that isn't one about organizational structure on its face, but it's one about value. I think that what you're doing is you're changing your relationship to the organization from one of permission seeking to one of value seeking. And I think when you make that fundamental change internally and you use that language and you take actions to support it, people will join you. I've seen a lot of very siloed structured organizations, but I have never found the person inside them that said, I do not want to get to the big bag of money at the end of my sort of company journey. Everyone wants to be successful. Everyone wants to be happy. And often what we're trying to do is we're trying to figure out the right way to match the solution that we see to the desire that they're seeking. And I think when you can do that, it's both magical and it's hugely valuable. And at that point, the organizational components really disappear because now we're talking about value. I don't want to pretend that organizational structure doesn't exist, and I don't want to pretend that there aren't organizations in which certain kinds of permission are going to be required. You have to be very careful about where you choose in your organization to test these waters. People's security concerns are valid. What goes into a build, how a build gets out in the world, how software gets created. People care deeply about these things, and often the structure that exists around them is there for a reason. So choose carefully and choose wisely. The goal is not to get you tilting at windmills. The goal is to take like clear, responsible steps toward alleviating the problems that you see using the tooling that you're going to learn in this class.